Does a VPN protect me from telemetry and other data gathering? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. It's not surprising that privacy concerns are on the rise. Every time we turn on our computer, we're sending data somewhere. A VPN, or a virtual private network, protects against some kinds of data leakage, but not the data leakage you're worried about. First, let's talk about telemetry, just what it is. From Wikipedia, telemetry is the in situ collection of measurements or other data at remote points and their automatic transmission to receiving equipment, telecommunication, for monitoring. Here are some examples of telemetry as it occurs on our computers. Windows sends anonymous usage information back to Microsoft so developers can better understand how the system is used. Windows sends error information back to Microsoft so developers can better understand and fix errors. Applications send information back to their creators for similar purposes. Web browsers send information back to the browser creators for similar purposes. And yeah, web browsers send information back to the servers hosting the web pages users are visiting. Basically, any data that is silently collected and sent back to a central location for analysis can be considered telemetry. It's really just another fancy word for data collection. Now, to be clear, not all telemetry is bad. Some companies really do use the information to improve their products. Sometimes the telemetry is what makes services remember things, like the fact that we're logged in or our progress in the most recent video we watched online. Now, depending on your level of trust in the organizations involved, data collection on your computer may be of great concern or no concern at all. For example, information claimed to be collected anonymously might not be. Sometimes this is intentional deception. Sometimes, though, it comes to light after the fact that correlation between anonymous data and personal data can be derived with enough analysis. You may or may not believe that the software creator is using the information only to make their software better. For example, some people are concerned that information being relayed to Microsoft or Google or Facebook or others is being used to train AI models. In the worst case, data could be turned over to law enforcement or oppressive regimes with potentially severe consequences. I don't necessarily believe most of the concerns, but I definitely understand that some people do. Now, a VPN encrypts your communications between your computer and the VPN provider. No one along that path can see your data. Not other Wi-Fi or network users, not the people managing the network between your computer and the VPN provider. The connection between the VPN provider and the rest of the internet, however, is unaffected. A VPN only adds encryption as far as that provider's servers, not beyond. A VPN can also mask your location, making it look like you are somewhere other than you truly are, and connecting via an IP address that is not your actual IP address. None of that has anything to do with telemetry. One way to look at it is this. A VPN provides additional security to the telemetry data that continues to be collected regardless. For example, we might envision the information flow like this. Your machine on one side, telemetry data being sent to the servers of the service you use. That's basically telemetry transmission without a VPN. As you use your computer, telemetry information is being sent to whoever is collecting it. If, however, we now add a VPN to the mix, well, what happens is the telemetry data is still sent from your computer to the servers that you're using. However, they have encryption, but only between your computer and the VPN service. Ultimately, it hasn't changed the telemetry data that's being collected or where it's going. The only thing that's changed is that the transmission of that data between your computer as far as the VPN service has an additional layer of protection from being snooped on. That's it. a VPN doesn't affect data collection at all. The best thing you could do to avoid data collection is to opt out. By that, I mean when you install Windows or any other operating system, or set up a new app, pay attention to all of the options offered along the way. If they mention sharing data, if that concerns you, turn it off. To see many of these options, you may need to select a custom rather than a default installation. You can imagine, many companies like data collection, and they like to make it the default. Now, I've always recommended that you choose custom installations anyway for several reasons, but this ability to opt out from data collection, if it's offered, is one more. Now, the next thing you could do, of course, is to choose tools that don't collect data or tools that respect your decisions about data sharing. Unfortunately, this is harder than it seems, since you're trusting that the tools are being honest about what they do and they don't collect. Windows gets a lot of bad press for the amount of data it appears to collect that is not under your control. If that's a concern, and to be clear, I don't consider it one, the best way to deal with it is not to use Windows. Yeah, there are tools and registry hacks and other techniques that claim to cripple Windows' ability to collect data. I'm not a fan. I consider them risky, and honestly, they're likely to be subverted by each subsequent version of Windows. Web browsers are a special case. There are a few things you could do to limit the amount of data being collected by the websites you visit. Disable third-party cookies in your browser's settings. This is usually the default these days. Install a privacy-focused extension, like Privacy Badger. Install an ad blocker. Reduce the number of extensions you install. Each has the potential to collect information. Make certain your browser and other software is up to date. Make certain your security software is running and up to date and being updated regularly. Ultimately, yes, some data sharing is inevitable, and as I mentioned previously, some of it is actually desirable. It enables much of the functionality we expect online. But that doesn't mean we really have to share more than we want to. If you feel you need to use a VPN, most of us don't, then use a VPN. That's fine. Just don't expect it to impact data collection and telemetry in any way. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/178489. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.